Hello, and welcome to part 3 of the first of the 3 weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. In part 2, you were introduced to Require.js, which is included in Oracle Jet to provide solutions for lazy loading of application resources and modularity. In this part, you will be introduced to the Require.js configuration file, which is used to configure Oracle Jet applications. The main.js file, which provides the entry point discussed in the previous part, in other words, the require block, provides something else as well. When you look at the top of the main.js file, you see a section called requirejs.config. This is the configuration block, which is defined by requirejs. Here you define the paths to the libraries that are used in the application. Notice that there's a reference here to libs, knockout, libs, jQuery, and so on. However, when you look inside the source folder, you will not see a libs folder here. To see those libraries, what you need is to build the application. When you run ojet serve, the application is built and it is also opened into the browser. If you don't want to open the application into the browser, but simply build it, what you would do is you would type ojet and build. This simply builds the application. What that means is that a web folder is generated. You do your work in the source folder, while when you do ojet build or ojet serve, a web folder is created. This is your staging directory, and in that folder you will find a libs folder generated based on the fact that you have a list of libraries in the main.js file. So you can see here libs knockout is libs knockout, and then inside there's a reference to the debug version of the knockout library, which is found within that folder. All the references you find here are references to the JS libs folder in the web folder, which you will see when you build the application. In this part, you have learned about the Require.js configuration file. The Require.js configuration file is an important file in any Oracle Jet application. It lets you configure the location of the libraries you will need to use in your Oracle Jet application. For your homework exercise, play with the code related to this part, try changing the path for a library to something incorrect, and see what errors are shown.